2NURFM, a broadcast service of the University of Newcastle.
Talk, you want to have a look at some education toys, some things that actually get the kids away from the technology. This is great. Some great ideas here. Up there for thinking.
Yeah, so I want to put you in a place you're not wanting to go, which is into thinking about gifts for the holidays for kids. But I think a few of these ideas might take a few moments to plan. So for the parents heading home from school or those noting this as they might watch it on YouTube later, I think for early, middle and older kids, we want to build in traditional literacy and numeracy, but also the skills we've talked about all year: well-being, critical thinking, problem solving, and creativity. And I think we have to make this the holiday season we go low tech with our families and with our maybe nieces and nephews and neighbors. So for young children, the traditional toys of bath books, blocks, drawing materials, and the opportunities to even have a special chair to do reading in, like an old rocker. Children love to be rocked in the evening. Imagine if you got your child a rocking chair that became your reading center in the evening. It becomes a wonderful opportunity to create a space in your home, a chance to build literacy, because as we've talked, there's two components to literacy. One is actually reading, and the other is feeling nurtured. So if you combine a young child sitting on your lap reading a story every night as a habit, you've created a caring, loving environment, as well as the opportunity to build literacy skills that will never be lost for their whole lifetime. So I'd go old school retro for our younger children.
Third bonus point on this, quiet household of a night.
Yes, absolutely. Create a calmness, right?
Absolutely.
Now, turn stuff off. For the kids that might be early primary to early secondary, I think we have to create a little activity center, whether you live in an apartment or a flat or you live in a small home or a large home. If you create a center, a corner of your house that might not be the best used right now, you get a carpet and you might get a little pop-up tent, some of those that you might see at the beach, or there's cheap ones, you might have one stuck in the attic somewhere, and you create a center. That's the child's little escape, a little fort where they might go in and build and make and design, and you equip it with PVC piping that's designed for kids so it doesn't have sharp edges, a little building center, they can make stuff. You could even get a little hard hat, and that's their building center. Boys and girls love to make stuff. You can also, in that place, allow them to have a little reading library for their books, and you can have them make some books with paper and pens and drawing materials. For slightly older kids, I think it starts with what their passion is. If they're interested in birds, some bird books of Australia mixed in with a pair of binoculars. And then you're building in a walk through the bush and you're looking for the birds. So you've done two things. You've increased well-being and time with your family. Plus the kids love it if that's their thing. Mm. If they're interested in surfboards, there's some wonderful books around surfboards, building them, making them, the designs of them. And then you can build in the opportunity to be with your child when they're surfing because you're spotting them anyway. If they're interested in cooking, cookbooks and help them design. What should our menu be for the week ahead? And they help with the cookbook, and they help with the cooking and the reading. Build the literacy into activity, and we're combining things that could make this the Christmas where families really grow together as opposed to hand each other the iPad and go apart.
Again, I know we've spoken about this in the past, but latching onto that idea again, John, of you can learn by learning about the things that you're naturally passionate about, so you sort of learn how to learn in a way.
Yes, and if you think about Aboriginal history, and so many kids are turned on to the stories of Indigenous culture, if you're taking a trip this next year and you were going to stop off at a spot and learn about Indigenous culture in that region, you might buy the book and story of the 50,000-year history. Or if you had the chance to go to Uluru next winter for a conference and your children could come along, wouldn't it be amazing if you read about the history of that most amazing spot in the Northern Territory?
Which we could also translate that to any area that you may be electing to go on holidays to. So you, even if you're going to the Gold Coast, just pick a history of the Gold Coast. Yep. What happens there? Connect the reading
to their passion, and you'll get all of a sudden kids reading. The key for literacy isn't more literacy instruction, it's more reading. And it doesn't really matter as long as they are. But if you build that into activity and you build it into what the students are excited about, all of a sudden you won't have fighting, you'll have kids who are excited. And then there are opportunities for them to develop their own with a journal, a blank journal for a kid who loves to write, a beautiful leather-bound journal for them to write their stories in, could be the keepsake they remember the rest of their life.
And the most important thing, no phone charger at all. We're just not going to have any of those this Christmas, John.
I think there's enough of that, and we'll get plenty in January when they all go on sale, but I think we need to turn stuff off and spend time together, get busy, get creative, and start to make stuff that builds a future together.
John, all of that sounds fantastic. fantastic. I just need some kids to go with the gifts now.
Yes.
All right, John, thanks. We'll talk to you next time. There is Professor John Fischetti talking all the education and some great educational gifts there for the silly season just around the corner. 2NURFM 103.7.